Okay, so this is the review for test one. And what I'm going to do is go over each of the questions and sort of verbally and visually help you understand why the number or the question is what it is. So, question one, the SPCA collects the following data about the dogs. This is a key word, the dogs that they house. Okay, so given that we're looking at the dogs that they house, in this case, we want to focus on, sorry, we want to focus on the fact that this is categorical data because of the fact that they're not focusing on how many dogs, they're focusing on actually the type of dog. So, bear with me for a second, let me just adjust this for. I should be able to write on this. Okay, so we're focusing on the dog that they house. So in this case, which data is categorical? And so in this case, our answer should be breed. They're not collecting anything about the age and the weight. Both of these are numerical. Cost, numerical, and this is discrete data. So the only one that is categorical is breed, because it would say something to the effect of, you know, this dog is a German Shepherd, or this dog is a mutt, you know, whatever the question. Second question, which variable about German Shepherds is most likely to be described by a normal model? So remember, for a normal model, we're looking for the bell curve. So it has to be something that has some sort of numerical value, and it has to be labeled on a number line from low to high, and it's also something that would have some sort of semblance where the bulk of the data would fall between, you know, the 68, 95, 99.7% rule. So if we look at these, age would not really be normally distributed. Weight would, because you get all types of dogs. Unfortunately, what we find, and in this case, they happen to mention German Shepherds. The age of German Shepherds should follow a normal progression. Weight, however, may vary, and you may have a normal distribution. Breed, no. Number of days housed, no. Veterinary cost, no. Because it would vary specific dog to dog, in the sense that most dogs that are placed in an SPCA. You know, situation where they're being housed. Typically, young dogs are adopted quickly, so that would im immediately eliminate much of our population as far as that age goes, and so therefore causing the data to be skewed if it were just age. So weight would probably be the most obvious of the data pieces that would be normally distributed, because you can get skinny dogs, fat dogs, normal weight dogs, and any range in between there as a dog is being taken care of. All right, for number three, the SPCA has kept the data records over the past 20 years. If they want to show the trend in the number of dogs they have housed, what kind of data should they make? And so the key word here, past 20 years, so we're looking at time. So immediately you should have chosen time plot. So far our answers should be D, B, and D. Number 14, the veterinary bill for dogs are summarized in the OGIV, OGIV, below, however you say it. They want to estimate the IQR. All right, so the first thing we need to do for the IQR is we need to find the 25th percent and the 75th percent value. So this is the 30 right here. In between here would be an equivalent 25%, and if I come down the middle, this would probably hit about the middle here, which would mean this is about 75. The Q3 is the 75th percent. So here's 70. 75th percent would be the halfway mark here. And then I come down here. This is about 175. So think of it this way. The Q1 is your 25th percent. And obviously the Q3, that's the 75th percent. So the scores, and these are the percents here. So I'm looking for the scores that are the 25th percent and the 75th percent, which is why I'm marking these labels. I'm then taking these and bringing them down to, find a comparable distance between these. So IQR is simply Q3 minus Q1, so 175 minus 75, and you get 100, which is answer choice B. Okay, number five. In number five, last weekend, police ticketed 18 men whose mean speed was 72 miles per hour. So 18 is a frequency. I'm already thinking they're going to compare men and women. All right, and they're going to give us a score. So they gave us a score of 72. Think of that as your X. So men, 72, 18 had that speed. And 30 women, that's a frequency, had an average speed of 64. Overall, what was the mean speed of all the people ticketed? So that goes back to the formula where our third column is x times f. So basically, we're going to do 72 times 18. Instead of having to do 72 times 18 and actually adding them up and dividing, we can just multiply, which gives us 1296 for this part. 64 times 30, that puts us at, let's see, that puts us at 1920. And so what we want to do is we want two columns, we want to sum them up. So the sum of frequencies, or the sum of f, is simply 48. And if I add 1920 and 1296, this gives me 3216. What I want to do next is the formula is a sum. Let's see here, if I can fit it in. I'm going to have to write it here. It's the sum of x times f, which in our case is 3216, divided by the sum of f, which is the sum of frequencies, which is 48. When you do the division, so 3216 divided by 48, you should get 67 miles per hour, which is answer choice B. Okay? Alright, let's look at number six. On number six, it says, which is true of the data shown in the histogram? So I'm looking at this, and I can see it's a left skew. If you remember, the left skew is where the larger numbers are more prolific. Remember, these are the high values. So we can definitely say it's not one. We can rule that out. By rule of thumb, that means that the mode is sitting here. The mean is bigger than the median is bigger than the mean. So in this case, the mean is probably smaller than the median holds true. So anything with the two applies. So this does not apply, this does not apply, and this does not apply because it includes the one. Now the question is it C or D? That depends. We should use the median and IQR to summarize the data. Yes, you should. And so your answer choice for this one should be C. Remember in class I talked to you about the love affairs, and I said to you, when we're normally distributed, we want the mean and we want the standard deviation. But when love goes askew, left or right skew, doesn't matter, we want to use the median and the IQR because these are robust in nature. They're not as malleable as the mean. The mean and standard deviation are what we call malleable. They go with the flow, remember the example? So robust meaning they're sturdy, they're hard to move around. Okay, number seven. On number seven, I'm looking at the distribution, and what you need to do is don't focus on the 40s because that may throw you off. I would focus on the fact that this is 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 180, 190, 200, 210. Okay? And so, with that stated, I'm looking at this distribution and I'm thinking that these two guys are outliers, and I'm thinking that maybe I'll cut this off somewhere here. So, if I'm looking at these two distances, I'm looking from 110 to 210, which is a difference of 100. Remember, range rule of thumb was range divided by 4, which gave you approximately, in this case, 100 divided by 4, which is answer choice E, 25. Okay. You got to look at your notes, okay? Because I know a lot of this stuff, it's a ton of definitions. And don't think I don't feel your pain. Because as a teacher, my goal is to get you to understand this as best I can. But it's difficult to do, you guys, especially those of you who chose a 2 day a week. I'm sweating. I'm sweating for you. I've never done a 2 a week. I don't think anybody in our campus even wanted to touch that class because they're terrified of the pacing. But I have faith in you. I think the Monday, Wednesday crew is going to do fantastic. So, especially using the videos that I'm going to start giving you to help you and balance you out. So, hopefully, you'll use them. Okay, so here's question number eight. If we want to discuss any gaps, here's a key, gaps and clusters in the data, which of the following should not be used? All right. So, for this one, keep in mind that the histogram, it does show those. So does the stem and leaf plot. So does the dot plot. You can see that up here. However, the box plot, remember, all it does is group data into, I guess, intervals of 25. There, I mean, you might get an outlier, but you don't see gaps and you don't see clusters. So D would be your choice for that. In the CRAM, I talk about this, all of the different strengths and weaknesses of these. Remember, I gave you that to use for review purposes. All right, question nine. Suppose a normal distribution model describes the number of pages printer ink cartridges last. If we keep track of the printed pages for the 47 printers at the company's office, which must be true. So, the page counts for those cartridges will be normally distributed. I don't think that's going to be true. So, I'm going to rule this one out. The histogram would be symmetric. No, well, it would not. Think about what an ink cartridge is and how it's used. Okay, 95% of those page counts will be between two standard deviations of the mean, so we're assuming it's a distributed normally. No, none of these. There's answer choice E for that one. Remember, normal distribution would mean that the values have to go from low to high and increase tremendously in the middle at some point. In an ink cartridge situation, you're running out. So if anything, you're going to be looking at extremes, especially if you're looking at something like 47 pages exactly. So, suppose that the normal model describes a fuel economy for auto Okay, so automobiles and that a standard, a Saturn has a standard Z score of 2.2. So this is an interpretation question. What this includes, remember what I said about 2.2 as a standard deviation? This is actually above the 2, so you're looking for something that is going to say that you are better than. Look for that verbiage, and I'm already seeing it here. So let me read these out. Let's see. You get 2.2 more than the average car. Not necessarily. That's not what a standard deviation is. You get 2.2 times the gas mileage of the average car. I don't know about that one. I'll think that one. You would achieve fuel economy that is 2.2 standard deviations better than the average car. This is it right here, folks. There's no question. Because if you recall, the standard deviation, if this is the average, and I'm telling you the standard deviation is 2.2, I'm just about here. And this is the average sitting right here. So yes, I am 2.2 standard deviations above the average. All right, let's see how many minutes I'm into this video. I don't want to shut it off either. Let's see. 16 minutes in. Let me go ahead and pause this because I don't want the file to exceed. I will continue on the next video with numbers 11 to 15.